NGO staff have a very specific position because they are people caring for people. Their soft skills are extremely important. But every mistake that they make in real life can have dramatic consequences.
I wanted to talk to you because I have a problem.
Safeguarding, it's not a new topic. It's not something that people within the aid sector are unfamiliar with. It's the issue of scalability. So trying to make learning as accessible to people as possible, as relevant to people as possible, but also thinking about how to reach as many people as possible, because demand for any learning is incredibly high, as you can appreciate.
Why did you not tell your husband when this thing first started?
If I had, he would have stormed into the office.
I'm the Global Innovation Director at the Humanitarian Leadership Academy. I'm responsible for finding interesting new ways of learning and bringing these new ways of learning into the aid sector through our learning platform, Kaya.
So BODYSWAPS is essentially a flight simulator for soft skills. It puts you in realistic simulations where you get to interact workplace scenarios with virtual humans. But uniquely, you can swap body, you can change perspective with them to see yourself from where they are, to be impacted by yourself. That's when you build self-awareness and self-reflection. That's when you learn how you uniquely can progress wherever and whenever you want, and to prepare yourself for the real world. It's been demonstrated academically that VR impacts behavior at a subconscious level, and it's managed to achieve what the holy grail of learning is, which is to actually change behavior, to solidify new habits in the workplace on a daily basis.
The possibilities are limitless, really. Border control and negotiations, for example, liaising with the local communities on how they can get a project going.
Being able to body swap is quite an exciting opportunity, I think, to see how we can incorporate this into our program potentially in the future.